Good afternoon, everybody. It is Sunday, November 4th, if I have that date correct.
Or is it the 3rd?
Saturday, November 3rd. No,
well,
it's Sunday.
No, it's Sunday. That much
it
I know.
Is the 4th. It's Sunday the 4th, right? I think we're using the wrong day up to this point.
We're here in Belchertown for the Super Bowl. The Northampton Blue Devil Senior Division is going to take on the Wilbraham Bulldogs. I'm Andrew Shelfo. I'm joined here, as always, by... I won't say I'm joined here in the booth. I'm just joined here on this rickety, unstable...
Right. And we've been talking about it all day today.
This is an
engineering feat that we're actually able to broadcast to you. We are perched precariously on some... really unstable bleachers, to the credit of Andrew Kessen and Kessen Productions. They got here early, found the best spot that this less than ideal venue had to offer for filming this incredibly big game. This is the Super Bowl. These are the two best teams in this division. We're ready to kick it off.
Osberg booms the kick. It is received by the Bulldogs. Looking for some room on the right-hand side.
No way.
He is met.
That's
and
Kessen.
Brought down by... Number 34, Jasper Kessen.
There is no messing with Kessen on the corner on a kickoff. Jasper Kessen leads off the game with a solo tackle in the open field. That'll be first and 10 for the Wilbraham, what are they, the Falcons?
Bulldogs.
The Wilbraham Bulldogs? I thought we were Falcons.
Yeah.
The Falcons?
Greenfield is Bulldogs.
Oh. Yeah, these are the Falcons.
Well, the announcer here at this August venue steered me wrong. First and 10 for Wilbraham on their own 35-yard line. Take the snap. There's the handoff. Look at this room on the right-hand side. He's got first down and rumbles forward for more. That's a big boy, number 41 there, Rob.
Boy, he sure is. That's a beefy back, and he exploited the right
And he did a good job of keeping his legs moving, following his blockers, squaring up. That was a nice run. No huddle here.
And
put the pressure on the defense. There's a handoff for the left-hand side. Cuts it back up. He is brought down. Nice tackle there by Elijah Davis.
Yeah, and you know what? We could have been called for too many players on the field. The referee on the sideline was about to pull out his flag and didn't. Number 79, Jose Reyes, needs to do a better job getting off the field. And that's number 68, Greg Gashevitz, reports into the game.
Second and about 10 and a half here. There's the snap. There's a handoff to the up back. He's picking his way through the hole. Gain of about three there. Brought down by... He's going to try to catch a number there coming up off the ground.
That was 72.
That was 72.
That was Garbarini.
That was Garbarini
from an inside position.
And the noise you hear in the background here, that's the Northampton Blue Devil Junior Division.
Who are very excited about their victory.
Super Bowl champions, I might add, with a solid 22-0 victory over Greenfield in our first game of the doubleheader. Looking back to pass, he's got a receiver over his head, and that was almost picked off by Osborne. That brings up a fourth down. So after a good first play by the Wilbraham offense, they've kind of stalled here. Now it's fourth down and 11. They're on their own 45-yard line, so it's a little bit of a decision here about what to do. Blue Devils have Elijah Davis back deep, and it looks like they are going to punt. There's the kick. It is fielded short.
Ooh. That was Matt Channel on
Matt
the reception.
Matt Channel fielded it. He was the up receiver. Fielded it cleanly, and he was met by Wilbraham, brought down. The Blue Devils will take over on their own 45.
Yeah, given how short that kick was, it was really no chance to run one back. It was sort of kicked right into the on-rushing Falcons.
The important thing is that he held onto the ball.
He did a nice
job. And now we'll get to see the Blue Devils take over on offense.
Yeah, and then Coach Frank Levin, Scott Channel, and Mike Gregashevitz, that trio has worked really hard. I know they had a good week of practice. This team is ready to play. They watched some film. They made some changes. It's going to be exciting to see this team this year.
I should mention that this is a rematch of an earlier game between these two where Wilbraham came out on top. There's a handoff to Davis through a big hole, gain of about six.
You know, that was a one-score game. It was an outstanding game. A couple of key turnovers were the difference, and quite frankly, one of the real impressive players for the Falcons, number 32, I think is not playing today. He's on IR.
I don't see him out there.
No, that gives the Devils that might be the advantage the Devils need.
There's the snap to Osborne.
There's
a handoff to Channel, and there wasn't really much there. And the scrum is called off by the referee's whistle. That's no gain. That'll bring up a third and two.
Yes, number 15, Burnish reports in the game. I know the Blue Devils like to mix it up on this play. I wouldn't be surprised to see a play action. Elijah Davis, you know, all eyes are going to be a number 21 Elijah Davis. That's what we all think is going to happen. I wouldn't be surprised, though, if there's a fake handoff and a little toss to the outside.
There's the pitch to Davis, looking for Zoom on the left, cuts it back up, he's got the first down, still on his feet, one guy to beat now.
He's gone.
Still, he's gone, he just blasted right past him, there's the touchdown. Nice run by Davis, 6-0 Blue Devils.
Real impressive, he broke two tackles and then he used his incredible speed to burst into the backfield, and in a foot race, my money's on Davis, touchdown Blue Devils.
That's a great play, great run by Davis, you're right, he did it all on that play. Hit through the hole, hit one of the would-be tacklers, and then when there was no one left for him to run over, he said, I'm going to run away from everybody, and went in for the score.
Impressive start for the Blue Devils. Three plays, first score. Blue Devils line up for the two-point conversion. This is just the kind of start that they wanted. They stopped the Falcons on defense, turn around, quick score on offense, take an early lead.
Yeah, that's a good way to start this game, getting the Wilbraham team on their heels a little bit. Osberg takes the snap. There's a pitch to Channel, cuts back up the middle. He is going to be stopped just short. He was probably about, I don't know, half a yard away.
Yeah, that was a play that just unfortunately didn't come together as quickly as we want. It's just a short little hesitation there at the line of scrimmage, and that led to a failed attempt. Blue Devils, however, take the lead. It's 6-0.
And let's see if they can keep that momentum going. They're certainly supported by the tremendously happy and pro Northampton crowd here. As you said, the juniors played earlier, so a lot of people are sticking around for the senior game as well. Osberg is getting the ball set for the kickoff. And looks like we're ready to go here. Checks right, checks left. And here's the kick. It's a good kick, deep kick. Fielded, oh, and it's dropped. That's a live ball. Still out there. Covered up finally on the 24-yard line. It's a good kick by Osberg. It's going to pin Wilbraham back deep.
And I'm hoping kicker Osberg noticed that number two had trouble catching the ball, and I'm hoping that the rest of the kicks go his way. Let's make him catch one before we stop kicking one to him.
And hopefully he'll have plenty of times to kick to him.
That's our hope.
Wilbraham takes over on their own 23-yard line.
Snappy paced offense.
There's the snap. There's the handoff to big number 41. Looking for Saloon right-hand side. He's found Saloon. There's a flag on the play.
A block in the back.
And he is finally brought down. Is that number 68? Alfredo Guzman. No, that's Andy Gregor-Shevitz bringing him down. And that's a penalty, a holding call on Wilbraham. That's going to bring him back 10 yards.
You know, it's we don't have a good vantage point here. We are precariously perched on some rusting bleachers. We're shaky, and we can't really see everything. But on that particular play, I saw left cornerback Osberg moving up to make the play. Next thing you know, he was lurching forward. It was pretty clear that he was not given an opportunity to make a play because of that illegal block.
Shotgun formation. There's the handoff.
Yeah, right.
That's the number 44, who was met by Davis.
That's Garbarini again. Garbarini. Second big play of the game.
And who else was in on that?
That boy is here to play today.
Also in that was Tim Burnish.
Yeah, number 70, known Gorman, was also in on that play. That's a second big play on the inside of that line by Garbarini. You know, last week we saw the interior lineman struggle with the size of we played Belchertown last week, and this week
there's a successful pass play. It's going to be well short though.
That's Levin sprinting out there from his linebacker position.
It was a good pass play, but I don't even know if it gained any yards.
It was about a four-yard gain. It was
third and 14. One thing I'm noticing here, Rob, we know that Wilbraham likes to play a spread formation, and they just don't have enough blockers in there to keep the defensive line off of them. There's the snap. There's the throw. It's throwing it deep. Looking for somebody. It's picked off by Osberg. He's returning it. He's to the 25, 35. Still has some room. Finally brought down. Great play by Osper. Takes it back to the 32-yard line of Wilbraham.
Yeah, I think, you know, after he made the interception, I think he tried to go for the touchdown. He probably would have been better off just staying along the sidelines, but I think he couldn't resist the opportunity for the pick six. And
we can't blame him for trying to go for the touchdown.
He went for the home run after the pick.
Yeah, Wilbraham is they, you mentioned before, they're going at a really, really quick pace on offense, but I don't think it's to their benefit yet.
But, you know, what a contrast to last week's game when the interior alignment of the Belchertown Granby team was just too much, and we came in with our beef, and that was a difference in the game. And so far, our quickness at the line seems to
There's
be the differentiator.
Davis playing quarterback, little wildcat formation, takes a snap, runs to his right. It's a gain of about six, and there's a flag.
That's
going to
be on Blue Devils. That's another block in the back there, too. It was right in front of us.
Early indication is a hold on the Blue Devils. That'll push him back 10 yards.
Holding Blue Devils.
Unnecessary, too.
And production manager Kesson acknowledges that that probably wasn't, that holding penalty didn't contribute anything. I mean, that was, Davis was already through the line. Just over enthusiastic offensive line play.
Well, that'll push the Blue Devils back 10 yards. That'll make it second and 20, if my math is correct, after a first and 10.
I think that was a spot foul? We might have brought it back about 9 yards or 8 yards or so, right?
It's going to be a first and 18. We'll call it 8.5.
Yeah, it's going to bring up
first and
18.
18.5. This time Osberg is in the shotgun formation. Sends Channel across the formation. He's looking to throw. He's got Channel in the clear. Oh, overthrows him by maybe a half a step.
You know, and that was a play where Osberg saw him sprinting out. Channel slowed down a little bit looking back for the ball. Osberg didn't anticipate Channel slowing down, and ball soared over his head. I don't know if that play was scheduled to be an out pattern or a corner pattern. If it was a corner pattern, receiver needs to stay in gate. If it's an out pattern, then that was ball was thrown to the wrong spot.
And I also wonder if the sun had any impact on how Channel was going to be catching that. Second and 18 and a half. There's the handoff to Davis. Gets through the hole. That's a gain of about 9. We bring up third and 10.
It does make you wonder when you see Davis with an average yard per carry right now of about 14 yards, why he's not handling the ball every other play. But, you know, we can't be giving it to the aircraft carrier in every play. We got to break it up a little bit. You know, Davis has had some injuries this year. He's been a little banged up, and we want to preserve him on both sides of the ball. But it's tempting just to
carry
him.
Third and 10. There's the pitch to Davis, looking for some room on the right. Woo. That Wilbraham defender did a great job of pushing the offensive lineman back and then wrapping up Davis for a loss of four.
Was that a wrap, or was that just a, I'm going to jump on you and splat you? I think that looked like a jump and splat kind of tackle.
It was a very effective play by their nose tackle.
Yeah.
Number 68, a large boy out there.
He is, and he's going to be somebody we're going to have to contend with all game. And if we can neutralize our inside linemen, there's going to be an opportunity for us to really penetrate because they just don't have the speed on the outside, absent number 32.
Fourth and 14. Davis in motion. Osberg back to pass. Throwing the ball up, looking for Davis. Davis, oh, caught it and couldn't hold on to it, bounced out of his hands.
Well, that was a nice throw by Osberg. He threw it in a place where only Davis could make the play and unfortunately couldn't quite hang on to it. Falcons take over first and 10.
Well, they went for the jugular there. Nice pass play, and they almost got away with it. But Wilbraham's going to take over on their own 36-yard line.
The leading receiver so far this year for the Blue Devils is number 33, Jared Levins, and neither of the first two pass plays went his way.
All right, Wilbraham has three backs in the backfield next to the quarterback who's in a shotgun. Referees are ready. Here we go. There's the snap. There's the handoff to 44. Looking for some room on the right. He is brought down first by Tim Burnish. And then he was helped out there. It looked like Ethan Gorman as well. And there was a flag on the play. Let's see what the call is.
Yeah, that was a motion penalty.
Was that a holding call?
That
was a legal motion on Wilbraham.
Hey, while they're marching off the penalty, and I think they will take the penalty, let's give us an opportunity to thank the Northampton Youth Football Board of Directors. They are led by president and coach for the Super Bowl champion juniors, Hank Girardin, vice president Ron Berenson, board MVP Diana Zinal, secretary Erica Lamana, registrar Taryn Johnson, and members and coaches Patrick Diggins and Brian Piseski, and Manfred Melcher.
So second and 10 after the Blue Devils decline the penalty. There's a flag on the play, and they do a little bit of a reverse that gains about 4 yards. And I think that's going to be another illegal motion. Let's wait and see what the call is.
And we can hear the coaches. We can hear the coaches for the Falcons.
He doesn't seem pleased with how
politely and enthusiastically and encouraging his players to play a little bit better.
He's politely urging them to play with a little bit of more intensity, I think. That marches them back 5 yards, so I think that was a legal motion. Bring up second and 15.
You know, the Falcons have shown an ability to move the ball. They've been their own worst enemy so far this game with turnovers and penalties.
There's pass play. It goes through the receiver's hands. The Wilbraham offense, they have a lot of moving parts. And
they do.
Just don't seem to be moving in sync at the moment.
And they don't give us a lot of time in between plays, but we do have time to thank the Northampton Youth Football Premium sponsors. They are the Northampton Police Relief Association, the Calvin Coolidge Nursing Home, and Angelic Builders. They stepped up. They reached deepest into their pockets, and all the families of this community appreciate their generosity.
There's a snap. Quarterback looking to throw. Sees a man open in the flat, and it's complete. In front of Osberg, that's a gain of about 10 yards there. It'll make it fourth down and six.
You know, that was a great throw and catch on the part of that receiver quarterback team right there. That was as good, well a thrown ball as you're going to see at this level. Threw it to only where his player could make a play.
Osberg was in the proper position. The quarterback just did a good job of putting the ball where only receiver could get it. Fourth down, looks like they're getting ready to punt. There's the snap. Here's the kick.
And that's poison.
And
that's poison.
They're going to stay away from it. I don't know. Did Davis touch that?
Yes.
He did not, thankfully. Blue Devils will take over. And that's the end of the first quarter. Okay, we're getting ready to start the second quarter here. The Blue Devils, after the punt, will take over on their own 36-yard line. They're leading 6-0 currently.
Yeah, it's going to be real important for the Blue Devils to at least get a couple of first downs here. We're noticing that Wilbraham offense is formidable, and the best way to handle that formidable offense is to keep him off the.
There's a hand off the channel through a big
off
hole.
Off the field.
He's still on his feet. That's a gain of about 7 yards there.
I like using channel that way. He's much better when he just hits the hole than when he tries to bounce it outside. He's very effective running in between his tackles. Sometimes he gets in a little trouble when he goes east-west. But well, those quick hits are very effective.
That's just what you were calling for, Rob. You know, line it up, get the 5 yards at a time. That's how you can build a sustained drive here.
You know, hit the hole, take what it gives you, keep your legs driving forward. Nice run by Channel. Good job by the offensive line to create the crack.
He's up second and four. Osberg in the shotgun formation takes the snap. There's a hit up to Davis, looking for some room on the left. He cuts it back up the middle. And then he's brought down after a gain of four, let's call it. Bring up third and two.
You know, they ran some of those misdirections out of the shotgun last week, and I think they made some modifications. Those were slow moving last week. That one was much, they obviously made some adjustments in their positioning before the handoff, because that play developed much more quickly than the plays that we saw last week.
And the Blue Devils are using a lot of their weapons. They're not just relying solely on Davis. They're giving it to Channel. Giving it to Davis. Let's see if they bring anybody else into play. Yeah, it looks like offsides. Osberg is keeping it himself. Tries to get a gain out of it. Maybe a half a yard. I didn't see a flag.
Wow. Now, there had to be a flag there. That was either offsides or that was illegal motion, because when the player jumped, we jumped, and that all happened before the snap. That had to be a penalty. And I think we thought so, too.
I know we're in a bad spot, and we can't see a lot, but we saw that, right?
Yeah.
There was some kind of penalty that should have been called.
Yeah, I'm not sure what was going on there. I mean,
that brings up a fourth and four.
I think there's about 2 yards to go.
Osberg takes the snap, hand off to Davis. Can't go there up the middle, and he's pushed back and falls down. That's unfortunate.
Yeah, that's a very unfortunate. You know, we like to see, a play like that with everybody stocked and sacked inside. We like to see Davis outside where he has an opportunity to break a tackle. He ran in the back of his player, and when he tried to bounce it outside, he simply tripped. It was just a log jam in the middle.
I think everyone was expecting a first down on that third down play after the penalty, the non-penalty, I should say.
At any rate,
well,
that
was
means...
also a very questionable spot. I got to tell you, I thought Osberg had at least gotten back to line of scrimmage and advanced the ball a little bit, and
so
I was perplexed at the spot.
So now Wilbraham's going to take over on offense. And as we said, they looked like they were close to clicking last time. Quarterback looking to throw. Oh, throws the ball up in the air.
Oh, it just dropped
into it. Osberg's hands, and he just dropped it.
Boy, that was right there. I think he picked his eyes up looking for the touchdown in that play. That was right there.
He's disappointed.
Well, he should be disappointed. That was right there. You got to catch those.
Now the sun is pretty low, getting low here. I don't know if that had any influence
on
it.
Yeah, it may have. But you know what? You got to come up with those. That was thrown right in the hit him right in the number 11.
There's a snap. It's through the quarterback's legs. The back has to fall on it. That's a loss of
about
10
yards. 7, 8, 9. Yeah. I think you're right. 10-yard loss. Good eyes by Shelfo.
It's the sunglasses that you don't have that are helping. That brings up a third and 20.
You know, again, I attribute that to just some nerves on the part of the line. Our quickness on the offensive line, I think, is unnerving the Falcons
line. There's a snap. He gets the handoff.
And there's a penalty.
Looking for some room on the left-hand side. Got one guy to beat. Still on his feet. Manages to get close to the first down marker before he's pushed out of bounds.
That one's coming back.
That's Gorman. And there's a flag on the play. Let's see what the call is.
That one's coming back, I think.
Calling a legal procedure on Wilbraham. So that play's going to be coming back. Yeah. Once again, Wilbraham shoots themselves in the foot. There's a lot of motion penalties here today.
Yeah, and
most of them have been called, too.
Yeah, and that's just sloppy. That's a huge penalty. That turns out to be about a 25-yard penalty. The 5 yards that they getting penalized, they added on to that the 20 that they gained on that play.
5 more yards.
Big penalty.
Replay third down.
But this is an explosive offense, and you know, one wonders to what degree their advanced start helped out the success of that play.
That is true. They're using this formation where they have three backs in the backfield, a receiver out to the right, and one out to the left. That doesn't leave a lot of blockers on the line.
And with our speed, we're getting through there.
Quarterback takes the snap, looking to hand off. Got someone to hand off through the hole, still on his feet. He is knocked out of bounds by Davis, close to the original line of scrimmage, and that's going to be about 10 yards short then of the first down. It brings up fourth and 9.5.
I got to tell you, Andrew, I was looking left, I was looking right. I couldn't find the ball on that one. I looked up, but the sun got in my eyes, and then I'm glad you knew what was going on. And I agree with this decision to go for it.
They have to go for it at this point. Fourth and 10, there's the snap. There's the handoff to number 2. He's looking for Zeru on the left-hand side where they like to run. He's pushed out of bounds about 6 yards short of the first down. Blue Devils will take over.
And that's about where they would have gotten the ball had we intercepted the last play. So it all sort of worked out.
Now it takes a time off the clock, too. So the Blue Devils are going to take over on their own 38-yard line, let's call it. I should point out again, we're not in our usual comfy, sumptuous booth.
No, I don't know what's worse, the shaking or the rust. And given the fact that we are not as svelte as we once were, I think we're putting extra strain on this rust up here. I can feel it crumbling beneath my feet.
On that happy note, it's first and 10. Osper takes the snap. There's the handoff to Davis. Gets through the first tackler, rumbles forward for a gain of 5.
You know, the ability to just break those arm tackles, he is just so strong in his lower body. He just drives those legs forward. You just can't arm tackle him. I mean, he's just going to break right through that.
Now, if he sees you lining up for an arm tackle, he's going to make you pay for that.
Yeah, that's
other.
Just, you know, try again, son.
Second and 5.
It's Brosnan in the game. He's in the fullback position, number 22.
Osberg and there's takes the snap. There's a channel. Channel, big hole. He's close to the first down. Dropped after a gain of about 4.
And I don't see a flag.
You were expecting one?
I was. I thought the Falcons jumped. Halftime.
Brings up third and call it 3. We'd like to see the Blue Devils get a first down.
because we're talking about the Wilbraham offense getting into a rhythm. We want to see the Blue Devils getting into a rhythm.
Burnish.
There's a handoff to Burnish, the up back. There's a fumble, and is recovered by Wilbraham.
Those are the kind of mistakes that lead to awfully bad things. I don't know if the handoff was muffed a little bit. All I know is Burnish got the ball, and next thing I knew, it was on the ground. I couldn't tell if Osberg missed the handoff or Burnish missed the reception, or if it was just a good play on the part of the defense. But the result is Wilbraham takes over first and 10 on the Hemp 42-yard line.
We have to hope that that's not something that they can build on here. We want to keep Wilbraham back on their heels.
Yeah, and that makes the turnovers 1-1.
There's the snap. The quarterback rolls to his right, throws the ball up. He's got a receiver.
Oh, nice
play. It is knocked away by Osberg. A nice play to turn his head around, find out where the ball was, and then knock it away at the last minute.
Yeah, I was very critical. I was very critical of Osberg's failure to come up with the interception last play, but that was an outstanding play. He had great recovery on that. He turned around, jumped, and made a super play. That's an outstanding defensive play by number 11, Osberg, out there on the corner.
Brings up a 2nd and 10. Wilbraham using this same formation pretty much the entire game. There's the snap. Quarterback rolls to his right, looking to throw. Drag down by big Jared Levins.
Yeah. That was a phenomenal defensive play. Levins is fast, he's strong, and he's got those long arms, and he just reached over the blocker, grabbed the quarterback by his jersey, and tossed him down like he was a paper doll.
That was a loss of, well, it's a big loss. That's going to bring up a 3rd and about 18. After the timeout, 3rd and 19 for Wilbraham. They're going backwards ever since they got that fumble. There's the snap, fake the handoff to one guy, handoff to the other guy, tackled by the third guy, Ethan Gorman. Drags him down. That's another loss.
You know, again, I'm really impressed with the play of our defensive line. This is just the exact opposite of last week. Sometimes quickness is what it takes, and sometimes just sheer power is what it takes. We've got our quickness team in, and they are doing the job on the defensive line, just taking turns. Greg Ishevitz, Gorman, Garbarini, just doing the job on that defensive line, using their speed and their agility.
Yeah, you got to wonder if Wilbraham's going to change up their offensive line here. They don't have enough guys to block. Not enough to punt. There's a high snap. There's the kick. It's wobbling. It's on the ground. It is touchdown. That's an 8-yard punt.
Yeah, and that's exactly where they lost the ball in the last fumble.
I don't know what that means. It means that they haven't really moved the ball much.
No, it just means that we fumbled. We lost it. It was a lot of back, a lot of forth. A lot of back, a lot of forth. And it's deja vu all over again.
It's all evening out so far.
We're back on the 42-yard line. Actually, we picked up a half a yard in that game. I think we're in the 42.5. Exactly where we lost the ball in the third down play.
That's true. It is where the fumble was lost.
I got to tell you, so far, you know, our most successful play is to get Davis outside a little bit where he has an opportunity to do some damage. We've been marginally successful running inside, but when we get Davis out in the wings, he's just been able to break tackles and make plays, and that's exactly what they're doing.
There's a pitch to Davis, looking for some room on the left. Runs over one guy, runs over two guys, still on his feet. He gets the first down. That's a gain of 11.
You know, that's exactly what we're talking about. He's just so dominant on the outside. When he has room and he has the ability to set up a tackler, he just drives those powerful legs into him. Little shake, and he is just a force when he runs. He runs like a linebacker.
Wilbraham's got to learn that one guy is not going to take him down.
No, and it's not just a function of hitting him. You got to hit him. You got to wrap up, and then you need some help.
Osberg takes the snap. There's the handoff. A hole up the middle. It was Davis again. Gain of, let's call it 4.
Yeah, they're going to the aircraft carrier.
With the Gary brought down by Gasanway.
Yeah, you know, now a little play action to Davis might be real powerful here. I'd love to see a little fake to Davis and then a little play action pass. I think they'll have, you know, some opportunities out. That's a 2-minute warning, Andrew.
2-minute warning for the first half.
2-minute warning.
I would like to see, before we go to play action, I say give it to Davis a couple more times.
Well, you know, I wouldn't be disappointed with that scheme. And here it is. He's in the Wildcat.
Here's the Wildcat formation. Osberg out to the right, channel out to the left. Davis takes the snap, looking to run to his right. Cuts it back up the middle. Met just past the line of scrimmage. That's a gain of maybe a yard.
You know, again, he's as effective as he's been. He has had some injuries this year, and although he does have halftime coming up,
Well, I think also if you're lining up Davis as the quarterback, is there anybody around here who thinks he's not going to run with it?
Well, you know, he has hucked him. He's got that great arm, and he's fired some down. He you know, it tends to, and here comes, I think this is going to be one of those Davis step back and fire over the top. Look for Osberg out on the right as a primary receiver.
39, Davis takes the snap. One step forward, looking to throw. He gets the ball away. It's up. Caught by Levins. Comes out of nowhere to make the catch. Wilbraham, that defender, had lined himself up for what he thought was an easy interception.
Yeah, Osberg was over the top of the receiver. Had the ball been thrown over the Falcon, it would have gone to Osberg. And unfortunately, the ball was thrown under. But fortunately, Levins was all over that. He read that perfectly and caught it in midair. First down, Blue Devils. Wow.
After the outstanding catch by Jared Levins, Blue Devils have first down, 10 yards to go. Looks like on the Wilbraham 30-yard line, I'll call it. Osberg is up under center. He's got Davis and Channel and Joe Brosnan in the backfield. Oh, there's a throw. Got Levins wide open, and he is going to score.
That time the pass was intended for Levins, and he caught it.
You know, that has been their go-to offensive play. We were talking about a little play action. We saw it there. Levins was wide open. Osberg hit him in stride. Touchdown, Blue Devils. That's a 12-0 lead.
That's a big defensive breakdown by Wilbraham because Levins was wide open.
But, you know, that was the Davis effect. You know, those cornerbacks were creeping up. They were creeping up. They knew they needed to because if Elijah gets outside, he's just way too much of a threat. The Davis effect led to a Levins opening, and Levins caught it. Touchdown, Blue Devils.
So here we go for the two-point conversion try. They have Osberg split way out to the left. Channel now in the Wildcat formation. Takes the snap, runs to his left. He's going to try to get the corner.
He does!
Referee kept us in suspense a little bit because we can't really see that corner of the end zone. He gets in for the two-point conversion. That makes the score 14-0 Blue Devils.
That's a huge score here as time is nearing the end of the first half.
Yeah, hey, that's hard for Wilbraham to overcome that score late in the first half.
Hey, and let's give some props to some of our other sponsors. The Gold Major sponsors include Pioneer Landscapes, Inc., MRW, Connected LLC, Liquors 44, Attorney Mark A. Tanner, Bacon Wilson, Osberg & Associates, Florence Savings Bank, and the World War II Club.
The Deuce.
Blue sponsors include Collective Copies, Newman's Construction, Goggins Real Estate, Joe's Pizza, the Whalen Insurance Agency. Special thanks also goes to blue sponsors, the Dove Business Associates, Valley Home Improvement Incorporated, Weber & Grinnell Insurance, the Blue Bonnet Diner, and Strides.
All right, here we go, Rob. Let's see if Osberg remembers that number two had a little trouble handling the kickoff last time. There's the kick.
No, that's
goes
over his head.
Over the head. Ooh, nice grab by number 33. Gets it in. Now he's going to try to run. Met by Jared Levins. Pretty good return after a shaky catch.
You know, it was a great catch. That ball looked like it was going to get over his head. You know, there's also some families who have stepped up, reached deep in their pockets, and contributed to the economic success of this program, and they include the Andy Morrison family, the Benedizics, the Ron Barrison family, Jim and Diana Zinal, the Tudrins, and the Bernishes. Thank you all so much for your generosity. This is not an inexpensive program to run. We want nice equipment that costs money. We want safe equipment that costs money, and we appreciate the generosity of local community sponsors for the benefit of these kids in our community.
Wilbraham will take over. Time running short here in the first half. Quarterback takes a snap. He's looking to throw. Throws the ball. It is caught. Receiver falls down after a gain of two.
I think I would have fallen down too rather than accepting a punishing tackle from number 121 Davis.
Davis was lining him up, that's for sure.
There's a sage young man. That was going to be a mean one.
So second, maybe that was a gain of about four. So second and six here. I would expect Wilbraham. I'm surprised they're not moving a little more quickly than
this. Well, they took a timeout. So that was a 20-second timeout, and time's back in.
Quarterback takes a snap, has a little trouble with it, throws the ball up. It's going to fall well short of the receiver.
Hey, there's number 14, Jared Fowler. We haven't called his name yet today, but boy, he has had an amazing season. And I think from our perspective, we'd love to see him get utilized in the offense as well. He's got great hands, and I wouldn't be surprised if sometime in the second half we don't see Jared Fowler catching a ball coming out of the backfield or put in at the fullback position to do a little running.
He also has good football instincts, as you saw in that last play. He
was perfect in the right coverage. Position. Yeah, perfect coverage. Good, very observant.
So here we have a little bit of trickery here. Student body right.
All against number 11, Osberg, who's imploring
the shotgun. He's going to take the snap. He's looking to throw. There's the throw. Number 44. Levins misses him.
Yeah, but
number 72,
there.
Garbarini is not going to miss him.
They got the truth. You know, Osberg was imploring his teammates to get out there. He was screaming. He was in an island.
And that's the end of the half.
Hey, we're here at the halftime of the seniors game with the three Super Bowl MVPs of this season. We have Troy Renner, number 55, Devontae Edmond, number 50, and number 9. Show them, you don't have your jersey on. That's number 9, Ryan Long. These guys anchored a defense this season. I think that led up 6 total points. Is that correct?
Yes.
Now, Troy and Devontae, you guys played on either side of the line, and we called it the vicious triangle with Ryan Long at middle linebacker. You guys were just menacing to the opposing defense. Tell me a little about your season, Troy.
Well, I had a lot of
Would you hold that up to the
usually
there we go.
I'm named for all the sacks. And Devontae, we're called the Bulldozers from our friend Melcher.
Melcher refers to the guy, hey Devontae, take the mic for a second now. Now you had some just punishing hits this year. Did the opposing team just start to shake when they saw you coming up the line of scrimmage?
Yeah, I think they did.
Were they talking?
Yeah, they were really.
Yeah. Well, we are on TV and we want to use language that's appropriate for all audiences. Hey, Ryan Long, take the mic here for a second. You played middle linebacker and you're also the fullback. You just were dominant in the middle of the field. If these two guys didn't get the job done, you were there to clean it up.
Well, but
tell me a little bit about your season and that amazing defense you guys had this year. Why don't you look up to the camera?
We had a good season on defense and offense. I think, like, the QB, Luke Melcher, did a really good job today filling in for Gavin.
Gavin Girardin had played QB all year, and he wasn't available for today. Did he have an injury?
Yeah, he was really sick.
He had the flu?
Yeah.
But we were surprised to see number 3 Melcher in there, but he did a great job.
Yeah.
Hey, the entire community wants to congratulate you guys on a great season. You learned early on if the defense is there to play, the team is there to play, and you guys had an amazing season. Congratulations.
Thank you.
To proceed to start the second half here, they're leading 14-0 over Wilbraham.
And this is the second time the Blue Devils have appeared in the Super Bowl. They were champs last year in a snowball game in which they beat the South Hadley Tigers. That's an onside kick. We got a channel's got to
jump
on
that. Someone better jump on that.
And
someone
I think
did.
He does. That's a nice play by number 9 Matty Channel. Heads up play.
That Channel got on that. That was their kickoff strategy was to hit it where they ain't. And then try to run and pick it up. But Matt Channel was right on top of that.
No, that's a super play by Channel. That's a good start by the Blue Devils. That could have been a disastrous start. With a 14-0 lead, I think we're going to see the Blue Devils really try to rely on their ground game. This is all about no penalties. This is about no fumbles. This is about no turnovers. This is about smooth execution. We've shown that our offensive line, though a little bit smaller than these very beefy Falcons, is much more athletic and much quicker, and they should use that to their advantage in the second half.
Osberg in the shotgun takes a snap. Does he hit up to Davis? Had a little trouble getting that ball, looked like. Rumbled forward for a game of maybe 3 yards. Really kind of guessing here. The sun's in my eyes. Can't really see the yardage markers.
Yeah, we are precariously perched on some rusting old bleachers. This is not optimal conditions. It's a really questionable venue for a game of this nature. And between the sun and our venue, this is challenging for our cameraman. The group at Kesson's Productions is using all sorts of conventions to try to bring you a quality broadcast. And we're here just trying to stay safe.
Osberg takes the snap, hand off to Davis, looking for his room on the left-hand side, winding his way through a bunch of Wilbraham players and no game.
Yeah, I think Wilbraham has figured out that we're going to come out a little conservative, and they have a couple extra guys lined up on the line there. There was a real nice block by number 59, Nick Sandoval, who did not play last week, and his absence was really noticed on the offensive line. Also, we've key blocks inside by Solly Berenson in that first half.
He brings up a 3rd and 9, and now they split Davis out to the right. I formation behind Osberg, takes the snap, looks to his right to Davis, throws the ball up.
Oh, nice
Davis
throw.
Is in the clear, makes the catch. It's down to the 25-yard line. A great throw by Oscar and a great catch by Davis.
Nice throw, nice catch. Boy, that's a second real nice, third real nice ball Osberg's thrown today. Threw one to Davis that was incomplete. Threw that great touchdown pass at the end of the half. And that was a post pattern. Hit him right in stride. Davis did a great job getting some space between he and double coverage. And Osberg threw it out there in a place that only Davis could make a play. And he came up, big time play.
Looked like the defenders forgot that no one had to stay close to Davis. They have to see where the ball's going.
And that's Higgins.
There's a handoff up the middle. Gain of five. Hey, solid play by Higgins.
You know, I am a big fan of Hammer and Hank Higgins. I love the way he runs. I love his determination inside. He runs with short, choppy, quick steps, and that's just so effective on those inside runs. I think his average yard per carry this year is about 5 or 6 yards. He's had a couple injury issues, which has limited his play in some games, but every time they use him, he comes up with a big play.
Brings up a second and five from the 20-yard line of Wilbraham. Davis once again split out to the right. Osberg under center. Takes the snap, fakes the throw, rolls to his left. He's going to keep it himself. He's through the line, into the secondary, has the first down. That's a gain of about 8. Nice run by Osberg.
Yeah, you know, again, that's the Davis factor. They had a couple extra guys out on the right side. You know, they had everybody leaning to the right to Davis. Osberg took it left. He was quick enough to get through those first tacklers and into that secondary first and... First and 10 from about the 12.
First and 10 from the 12, and it's great when you have a lot of things that the defense has to worry about. And we're seeing that so far on this drive. Osberg takes the snap. There's a pitch to channel.
Oh, nice.
Got
block
some room
by
on the right.
Keep going, Maddie.
Swung out of bounds at about the 10-yard line. It's a gain of about 2.5.
Yeah, one of the things we'd really like to see is, you know, just before they hit, rather than decelerating, accelerating that tackle, you know, take the hit right to the tackler. Second down and about 6 to go. That was about a 4 yard. It was about a 4 yard game.
They'll call that second down and 6 to go.
Real nice block by number 22, the fullback Brosnan on that.
Osberg takes the snap. There's a pitch to Davis looking for some room.
Oh, he's got some blockers. Oh, nice play.
Some blockers, but the still on his feet, still trying to push his way forward. Levins and Higgins did a great job of taking the first defender out of the play.
But I think they made a mistake there because they only needed one guy, and the other one should have gone to the next would-be tackler.
Yeah, the defensive back was able to flash in there and put the first hit on Davis.
Yeah, and then there was a second hit, and then there was a third hit, and then there was a fourth hit, and Davis was still up, and there was a fifth hit and a sixth hit, and by the time the seventh guy came, they finally got him down.
That means third and 11. We're deep in Wilbraham territory
I'm looking for Levins again. I'm looking for the corner pattern to Levins. I'm looking for the corner
Osberg
pattern.
Takes the snap, fakes the handoff.
I know,
we talked about it.
He's there's
open.
Our man.
He's going to get in there for the score.
That's Fowler. We talked
Fowler
about Fowler.
For the score. Rock, you called it. You said we're going to call his name again, and we did.
Yeah, it was. Somehow we just knew Jared Fowler was going to step in there and make a big play, and he just did. That's a touchdown pass. Osberg to Fowler. That makes the score. Blue Devils 20, Falcons nothing as they line up for the two-point conversion.
That was another nice throw by Osberg. And for all the kind of flash that we're seeing on the Wilbraham offense, the one that's really doing with the razzle-dazzle of the Blue Devils.
Boy, just misdirections, well-executed plays. Well, let's punch this across.
Osberg takes the snap.
Yes.
There's the handoff to Davis. Can't quite make it across. 20-0 Blue Devils.
But you know, this game at this point is going to boil down to lack of turnovers and effective defense. And you know, this is right now is the Blue Devils game to lose. They've just done everything Coach Levins needs them to do, and now it's a function of execution.
Yeah, you got a 20-point lead here in the third quarter. Running time, of course. So that means if, as you say, Rob, if on offense you can hold onto the ball and limit the opportunities for Wilbraham to get the ball, that's a pretty good recipe for success. Blue Devil will get ready to kick off. Osberg lines himself up.
And we wouldn't mind seeing a nice high soft one at number two. Let's see if he can make the play here. And
there's
that's
the
where
kick.
They kick it.
Kicking it in the soft spot. That's a live ball. Number four picks it up, looking for some room on his right. Eludes one tackler.
Not going to get away from Fowler.
Yeah, that's Fowler and Kessin again. Kessin making another big play on special teams. That's a second nice play that Kessin has made on special teams. Fowler, Kessin team up. That brings up first and 10 on their own 33-yard lines. Falcon take over, down 20.
Well, if their offense is ever going to start firing all cylinders, they better start doing it now.
Yeah, this Blue Devils are going to have an opportunity to pick one off here, and a timely interception will just might be too much for these Falcons to overcome.
Falcons come out in the shotgun formation. Two backs, one receiver left, one to the right. There's the handoff, looking for some room on the right.
No.
He is met by half of the defensive line, including Levins and
Gorman. Yeah, nice play. I'm just so impressed with the play of our interior line this game. This could be the best game they've had all season against a talented team. I mean, that trio in the middle has just been penetrating. They're just athleticism has just been too much for the Falcons.
Second and 10 for the Falcons. There's the shotgun snap. Looking for some room on the left. He has some room. Gets past Fowler.
Yeah,
not going to get past Gorman.
What a game he's having. What a game Gorman's having. He is everywhere. He's up the middle. He's right. He's left. He's just playing as a man possessed today.
Came down the line and stopped him after a gain of about a yard and a half.
Gets a well-earned break. Sandoval reports in on third down play. But Gorman has just had a monster game today.
Third and 8 for the Falcons. And if they don't get it here, they're going to have to think about punting. And that's not what they want to do. They're
not
deep
down
in their
20.
Own territory. There's motion.
No, there's this motion.
A couple people moved on that one.
Hey, while they're marking off the penalty, this gives us an opportunity to recognize, thank, and acknowledge the contributions from all the players. And we'll start with number 75, Tariq Sanders, who just reports into the game. He and his beefy partner, number 79, Jose Reyes, just were the key to that win last week. Bo Garbarini, number 72, is in a breakout season, and we've talked about Gorman. And there's a timeout on the play.
Timeout on the field. After the timeout, third and 13 for the Wilbraham Falcons. They're on their own 30-yard line. Moving backwards when they should be moving forwards. There's a low snap. There's a throw. Caught. That's about a 6-yard gain. That's not going to get on the first down.
That's going to bring up fourth and about 8. I'm questioning that call. We had a real good angle on it. Incomplete. One was calling complete. Doesn't matter.
I guess they're going to let it go.
Hey, we got to acknowledge the contribution of Wilfredo Guzman. Special acknowledgement to Solly Berenson, who has been in this program for 6 years. He's been a stalwart on that line. He comes to play every day, plays with an intensity. It really sets a tone on the line.
Fourth and 8. This is a big play. We want to see the Blue Devils shut him down. Levins gets in there. Incomplete pass. See, Levins, he timed that perfectly.
He did.
With the snap count. Got into the quarterback's face, forced him to throw him too early, and the ball was incomplete. Blue Devils are going to take over on downs. On the Wilbraham Falcons 36-yard line.
Just seeing the dejected Falcon team, their body language shows that they just look like a team that's sort of accepting their fate at this particular point. Not here today, Ryan Braden, who had a great season, number 40. We're real disappointed that he wasn't able to finish out the season with the Blue Devils. He really came on as an offensive player and just was a starter all season long, and his contribution has to be recognized as part of the success of the season. Number 34 veteran Jasper Kessin made two huge special teams plays today. We know about Kessin. There ain't no messing with
that kid. No messing with Kessin. Davis in the backfield as a quarterback takes the direct snap. Gets nowhere. Dragged down by a couple of Wilbraham Falcons.
Yeah, that was just poor blocking. I don't know if they blitzed. I think they got in there from the outside. Number 33, Jared Levins, has had a great game, and we've had some tremendous contributions all season from Javonte Grant, number 44, and number 23, Griffin Shaw. I think, in fact, last week, Griffin Shaw played his best game of the year. Newcomer Joey Brosna has, number 22, played fullback. He's been in on special teams and defense. What a great addition to the squad.
Still the Wildcat. Davis looking to throw. Has the ball up in the air. Osberg is open just over his head. Good throw by Davis, who was under a little bit of duress there in the backfield.
Yeah, that was that same thing. I think Osberg slowed up for a second, and I think that cost him a complete pass. You know, if that is a, if that's a post or an out pattern, you got to keep the legs going and try to run in that ball. And that little bit of a slow up just for a second was the difference between that play being successful and not. Want to acknowledge the contribution of number 16, Josh Rivera, number 15, Timmy Burnish, who's just been such an anchor for the Blue Devils. We talked about Fowler. He's had a big
third and 15. Osberg takes the snap. There's a pitch to Davis. A couple blockers in front. He has a big hole. He's through it. He's got the first down. Still on his feet. Still going. One guy to beat in for the touchdown.
Oh, that could be the icer. It could be the icing on the cake. What a run by Davis.
That's just a way to demoralize Wilbraham on that play.
Oh, especially after two stalwart defensive plays. And wait a minute, they're calling it off. He may have stepped out of bounds. He did step out of bounds.
At the 15-yard line.
That is not a touchdown. He's after a great run, but that is a first down. There is still hope for these Falcons. Number 12, Jeffrey Pearson. Number 10, Hank Higgins. 9, channel number 8, Jack Reed. Tangi Bader, new to the program, has just been very inspiring. Plays with all sorts of enthusiasm.
Osberg takes the snap. That's Higgins. Higgins up the middle. Finds his way. That's a gain of about 5 yards.
Again,
there.
You got to love his running style. Knees are forward, quick feet, great balance. You know, he's a seventh grader. He's going to be an impact player in this team last year. But for some injuries this year, which limited his time, he would have been a dominant player as well. And I think there's a timeout
on the field. After Wilbraham calls timeout, it'll be second and 4 for the Blue Devils. They're knocking on the door here. They're about at the five-yard line of Wilbraham. Osper's in a shotgun. Sends Davis in motion, takes the snap. He's looking to throw, looking for Davis, who's open. Touchdown!
Oh, what a game. That's his third touchdown pass today. Nice throw, nice catch. What a dominating performance.
How do you let Davis get that wide open in the end zone like that?
You know, it's just the athleticism. It's just, I think Wilbraham's just dejected it.
You may be right. We may be.
Hey, I also want to acknowledge the contributions from number 6, Jose Ortiz, number 3, Cyrus Carey. Now, here's a guy who, during the course of the year, every game he got better and better and better. And toward the end of the season, he's one of the reasons the Blue Devils had so much momentum coming into these playoffs. Eamon Powers, number 2, Kyle McGrath, number 1, and Chris Rosenfeld, number 0, round out this soon-to-be-crowned championship squad.
Osberg looking to throw. He's going to keep it himself. No, he's going to toss it into the end zone.
Two.
Davis for two.
Two.
Successful two-point conversion. Helped by Matthew Rod. What does that make
the score?
And that
makes it 28-0. I think that was the icing on the cake. I think the Blue Devils can start to feel good about this one. I wouldn't be surprised if, mysteriously, the time on the clock speeds up a little bit. You know, I have to spend a couple of minutes here because my son always tells him I never give him his due during these broadcasts. And I got to tell you, it's probably true. Now, my son, number 11, Ian Osberg, has had a great career. He's played in this program for 7 years. It's been a great experience for our family, and he's having such a great game today. I got to tell you, on my last official broadcast for Northampton Youth Football, I couldn't be prouder of what he's done and the kind of game he's having. 3 touchdown passes and playing some cornerback and
interception.
He's just having a great game, and congratulations to Ian on what has been a great career and finishing it off in style with just an over-the-top game.
After the kick from Osberg, fielded cleanly, returned for about 10 yards.
In fact, you know, a number of the veterans, the eighth graders who are graduate from this program, have parents who've contributed on the board, their coaches. I know Coach Levins had the opportunity to watch his son Jared just have a great season. Coach Greg Yashevitz will be back next year with his son. Coach Channel, his son Matt, you've just seen him blossom over the years. He's just been a great player, and he's been a vicious tackler there at safety. I think he's got a real future at the high school level as a defensive player. I love the angles he takes. I love the aggression with which he tackles. He's got a lot of good football ahead of him.
Wilbraham takes over. Shotgun formation, takes a snap. There's a little pitch pass out to the receiver. He gets a nice little gain of about 15.
Yeah, that was a most successful play we've seen from the Falcons this whole game. It was just a screen pass, just very perfectly run. Another guy I really want to talk about, and we talked about him being an impact player this half, is number 14, 11. Jared Fowler. Here's a kid who's just really found himself athletically this year, and he's been dominant, absolutely dominant on both sides of the ball. What a year he's had.
The low snap from the shotgun. Oh, the receiver had it. And then he just couldn't hold on to it. That would have been a gain of about 15, but it's going to come back second and 10.
Yeah, that was a nice throw, but Higgins and Kesson were out there. Also, really want to acknowledge the amazing season number 72 Bo Garbarini's had. Bo is a guy who started in this program as kind of a reluctant football player, and he's got big, he got fast, he got mean, and he just had a dominating year. Another one of the reasons why the Blue Devils are gonna leave this field today as champs.
Quarterback keeps it himself.
That's Kesson on the
tackle.
Gets close
to the first down. He may have gotten it. That was a heads-up play by the Wilbraham quarterback there to make something out of nothing after the low snap.
Now, a concern I have is after back-to-back championships at some of these levels, we may be looking at going back up into the big, mean, ugly division next year. This has been a lot of fun for these kids to play at this level. They've had a lot of competitive games, and that's the end of the – is that the end of the third quarter? End of the third quarter.
What down?
It's the beginning of the fourth quarter here, Andrew, and we're waiting for the Falcons to come out of the field. It's first and 10. They take over on the Blue Devils' 35-yard line. They're down 28-0. The Blue Devils, I know they want the shutout. I hear their coach extolling them to keep battling, to keep fighting, that the game is not over yet. Still have a quarter of football to play.
Shotgun snap, fakes the handoff.
Oh, that's going to be picked off.
It is up for grabs. Channel's got it. He's on his horse, looking for the pick six. Tackled at about the 42-yard line.
And that's just a super interception. Matty Channels was in perfect position. He made a great catch, great concentration. You know, all year long, Matty's had opportunities for pickoffs, and he finally gets a big one in the Super Bowl game. I'm glad we have it on film. I'm glad he got it in the final game of his youth football career. What a way to cap it off.
Blue Devils will take over. First and 10, just 41-yard line, let's call it. And I think, Rob, we were talking a little bit in the break here. This game is all over except for the time and the clock.
Yeah, you know, it's just the body language of the Falcons. I mean, they just look dejected, and I guess you can't blame them.
Osborne takes the snap, pitch to Davis, looking for some room on his left. Gets up there, he's close to the first down. Nice run by Davis.
Gain of about 9 yards on the play for Davis.
Yeah, and Higgins is bringing the play in, and he and Channel are sort of shuffling plays in and out. I wouldn't mind seeing the ball inside to Higgins. I really like the way he runs. He keeps his shoulders square to the play, keeps his legs moving, his supervision.
Osberg up in her center, takes the snap. There's a pitch to Higgins, looking for some room to the right. Cuts it back up. That's a gain of maybe a yard, yard and a half.
No, that was a yard, yard and a half is all we needed for
enough
a first down.
First down, that is
you know,
true.
And again, one of the things we talk about is, you know, one of the things you like to see in a runner is the ability to finish the run. And Higgins accelerated into the tackler, drove the tackler back for another yard or so, and that confirmed a first down on that play.
And he did a great job following his blockers, who did their job by opening up the hole. Osberg up in her center, takes the snap. There's the handoff.
That's Kesson.
To Kesson, looking for some room on the left. That's a solid gain for Kesson.
Yeah, positive yards. It's just what we like to see, and he did a great job hanging onto the ball there. It's about a 4-yard gain for Kesson. Nice job.
And as we like to say, Rob, you get 4 yards at a time, you're going to be in good shape.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, and Kesson's a guy who played corner, he plays safety, he plays special teams, and he's also used on offense and does a good job wherever coach puts him.
Got a nose for a ball, for the ball, and the passion for the game. That's what you like to see in these players.
You know, and he's not the biggest guy in the world, so he has to make up for it in toughness and determination, and he sure does.
Osbert took the snap there and handed it off to the up-back, Cy Carey, who was met right behind the scrimmage, no gain.
Yeah, that was, you know, that was, sometimes you have to give the defensive credit, and, you know, I think that was just a super defensive play right there.
Well, I think you're also seeing the coaches do a good job here of getting in some players who haven't gotten a lot of playing time during the year, but they're going to be able to say that they played in the Super Bowl, and that's great. Osberg up under center, takes the snap. There's the handoff to Higgins, looking for Zerun on the right, cuts it back up the middle. And he is brought down close to the first down marker.
Higgins with the carry.
That's just textbook technique by Higgins. Just great vision, great balance. Brings up a fourth down and about a yard or so.
Fourth and a yard. Let's see if we get the first down here and maybe be able to run out the clock here on this possession.
You know, the way the clock moves in this game is a great mystery to us. And with a 28-point differential, sometimes the clock tends to accelerate.
Osford breaks the huddle, brings the team up to the line of scrimmage. Takes the snap, rolls to his right. There's a throw, open for the catch. Who was that?
Yeah, that was number, was that number seven? It sure was.
Tangy Botter.
That was Tangy Bader on that play.
That's a great play by Botter. He's a first-year player. He's worked so hard this year to learn a game that's a little bit unfamiliar to him.
No, he comes from a foreign land, I understand, and he's just been loving it. Isle of Man is where he comes from. Could be the first catch in a youth football game from anybody from the Isle of Man.
Osper takes the snap. There's the handoff to Brosna. The up back, he rumbles forward for a gain of...
That's
another first down. Is that a 10-yard gain, looks like?
Yeah,
no,
and that's
a 5-yard gain.
Yeah,
Second and two.
You know, he's coming off the field right now, number 56, Berenson. He has had such a great game. He plays all year long against guys who are bigger than him, but he's never played against anybody who's more determined. I mean, that guy just does the job. He's just, yeah, that's number nine, Channel at QB. Inside
Channel
handoff to Brosna.
There's another handoff to Brosna. And there's just a big old pile that he runs into. No gain.
And that's going to bring up, what, about third and two? Is that what it looks like?
So it looks like third and about two here as the coaches continue to shuffle players in and out.
I think Channel will remain in there as the play caller. This is definitely two down territory. Again, a first down just keeps churning the clock. I'm looking for Higgins on this carry right here.
Channel takes the snap. There's a pitch to Higgins. Jasper Kesson, lead blocker. Higgins tries to string it to the outside, but he can't turn it upfield. That's no gain. Actually, a loss of about a yard. So that brings up fourth and four.
Yeah, and then the Blue Devils will definitely go for it here. They're just going to keep it simple, keep that clock moving, take their time, get up to the line of scrimmage, move it forward. You know, we talk about one player making all the difference on a team, and for us, it was certainly Elijah Davis. He's been the team MVP this year. Obviously, this Falcons team without number 32 isn't the same team we saw.
Channel takes the snap, rolls to his left, was looking to throw, ran out of time, and he's sacked. Loss of about 8 yards on that play.
You know, we brought in some very effective.
And there's a timeout on the field. After the timeout, Blue Devils will start off on defense after turning over on downs. Wilbraham having a last gasp maybe on offense.
Well,
this is snap, handoff, looking for someone on the left-hand side. That's number two. A little bit of a scat back.
Nice stick by Channel.
Channel, nice stick there.
Yeah, we've been shuffling players in and out, and they're getting the job done too. And here comes number two, Eamon Powers, in. So we did survey the announcers and the writers and the media, and there was a consensus MVP of this team. And that's number 21, Elijah Davis. He has had an amazing career. He has definitely anchored this Blue Devil team. He's been their aircraft carrier on offense. He's been their bulldozer on defense. He's just had an amazing season, and we want to congratulate Davis on his great season, anchoring this Blue Devil staff on both sides, anchoring this team, just being tough, being talented, being determined. He's got a great future ahead of him, and wherever he decides to take his talents, that city, that town, that community is going to benefit, and we sure hope it's right here in our hometown of Northampton.
It's been fun to watch him play. He brings it every play. Whether on offense or defense, he knows just what to do. And I've really enjoyed watching him. Wilbraham trying to make something positive out of nothing.
Powers on the tackle.
Powers comes in, makes the tackle. Good for him.
And that's a batter back in the game.
Tangi Batter back in the game.
Batter
and,
back.
Yeah, and number nine channel is reports out. Also see number 13 Nay in the game. Number six Ortiz in the game. Real exciting to see all these guys have an opportunity to get a piece of this action in today's game. Nice pass.
Nice pass, nice screen pass.
Oh, there's a super tackle by number 16.
That was Josh Rivera. Great tackle. There's the two-minute warning, Rob. As we know, running time here, so time running very short for Wilbraham to do anything.
Number 16, Rivera, gets a pat on the back from 21, Davis, who comes out of the game, and that's number 23, Griffin Shaw. Davis going to get a big congratulations from his coaches. Levins also reports out of the game.
So it's third and about four for Wilbraham. Takes the snap, looking to throw. He's flushed from the pocket, throws it up. It is complete in front of Rivera. And then he gets the first down. He's brought down by the entire secondary of the Blue Devils.
Yeah, that was Batter. That was number two, Powers. That was number 24, Javonte Granon, in that tackle. Very determined tackling on those Blue Devils. These are mostly seventh graders in the seventh and eighth grade game. And to see them playing with such toughness and determination bodes well for the fate of this team next year.
Low snap again, throws the ball up, had a man. Ooh, almost brought down by Pearson there. Slipped by him and is finally brought down by
Ortiz.
That number six.
That was Ortiz. He's a vicious hitter back there. Hey, there's a boy who plays with some spark. Nice play by number six Ortiz.
And Rob, let me take a moment and say, it's been fun doing these games these past couple of years. Gonna miss you in the booth next year, but feel free to stop by anytime you want.
I shall, and there's no better workmate than the workmates than the two of you guys, Andrew Shelfo, Andrew Kessen, the Andrew pairs, and that's gonna be a face mask.
So that's a big completion by Wilbraham. They got tackled down about the 10. I think there's gonna be a face mask tacked on at the end there, and now the Blue Devils are gonna have to fight for the shutout a little bit here.
Yes, they are. That's going to be half the distance to the goal line. That's going to bring a first and goal from about the five or the
first
six.
First and goal, right? Yeah, just about on the five-yard line. Yep. If they want the shutout, they're going to have to fight for it. Time's running short. Can't be more than 40, 50 seconds left. Let's see what they do. There's a shotgun snap. There's a handoff to the right. He's got room. Who was that? Number 24.
That's a touchdown.
That was Javonte Grant. Just couldn't push him out of bounds before he got into the score.
Number four. Well, you know what? Congratulations, the Falcons. They've had a great team. You know, this is no shame for the Blue Devils. They're out there. They're playing with seventh graders. They're working hard. They're doing the best they can and showed a lot of promise. That was a nice drive. Give credit where credit's due to the Falcons.
Now the lineup for the two-point conversion try. And here's that student body left formation that we saw earlier in the game. Quarterback takes the snap, looks to throw. Got it out in the flat with a lot of blockers in front of him. He gets in for the two-point conversion. And that's the game.
The ball game. Congratulations to Coach Levins. Congratulations to Coach Channel and Coach Grant Kashevitz. This is the second championship in a row for these Blue Devils. They have defended. They end this season as the Super Bowl champions.
Super Bowl champs, Northampton Youth Football League, Senior Division Blue Devils. Heck of a season. Congratulations to them.
We are out, and thank you very much, everybody.